In this video, I'm going to show you how to calculate the time difference in Excel. Hey guys, welcome to Excel Tutorial channel, and today I want to talk about something really important, time zones. A lot of people don't understand how they work or why they matter, but they do. And when it comes down to the business, if we can't figure out our client's time business, things get messy real quick. Today I'm going to show you how simple it is for Excel users like us with a few clicks of the mouse button, because let's face it, who has time for complicated stuff, right? So without any more ado, let's get started. But before that, if you haven't subscribed to the channel, please do it, because in the upcoming days we're gonna cover each and every functionality of Excel and full-fledged course for free. So let's get started. And here we have this sample sheet here. Okay, so we have a day shift timing and a night shift timing. So we have this employees name list, and this is another employees list, and we have a timing, timeout and time left. So we're gonna find the difference, time difference in Excel. So you must be wondering, if you haven't noticed until now, we have two time shifts. One time shift is we have single day time, like we have a 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. But we have 2 days time here, which is 9 p.m. to the next day of 5 a.m. So there is a little difference between two, but we will cover it in this video. So first, if you need to calculate the time difference, or you can say the time left between for Joseph and how much he has worked today, then the simple formula is very basic. So first part, we will discover the simple formula. Simple formula is very basic. If let's start with a simple formula that calculates the difference between two times in a single day. So we have the two times, which is of the single day. For that, we simply subtract the start time from the end time. So what is the end time here, which is the time two, minus or subtract with the time in. So you just enter like this and apply to all. Here it says 8 a.m., 7:49 a.m. And why it's showing the a.m., which is the, you know, the morning part, okay? So a.m. is used for the times in the night and morning, like after 12, and p.m. is used for the times in the afternoon and evening, which is the afternoon, which is also 12 p.m. To deal with this, we need to change the format of all this. Select all this range here, right click, click the format cells here, and after the format cell, you can do it however you want. Here first you need to go to the time and just simply select this. So we have this much time left for this one today, and he has worked for, like Oliver has worked like 7 hours 5 minutes and 7 hours 37 minutes, etc. So that's how you can simply apply the time difference with the help of this simple formula. So this is the part where the difference between two times in the same day. So what about difference between two times on two another days? So we have a 9 p.m. to 5 a.m. obviously the day will be apart from one day to another, right? But let's see, with the simple formula, can we really calculate it just right the way we have written, like a simple formula here? So it will always give us this hash, which says the dates and times that are negative or too large show as this with the hash operator. So dates and times which are negative, obviously it's a negative because we have included the 5 a.m. part and subtracted to the 9 p.m. so it will denote as this hash value. But if you want to clearly see this, you need to change the format of this particular range. How? Just select all this range here, click right and go to the format cell, and after the format cell just select general here. So it will just imply the decimal value. So here now we go to this formula again, select this, right click to the formula section here and format cell, and go to the general and click OK. So it will say minus 0.66 times has been left for Joseph here. Okay, so I know this particular value doesn't mean anything like that, and to correct this, what we're gonna do here is we will apply the time difference formula here with the help of if function. How are we gonna do that? Just let me press control Z and undo all these action and delete this. So now do understand this. If logical test. What will be our logical test? If this particular value, which is the time out, is greater than equal to this, which is the time in, then we want to just subtract it like that, right? Value if false, if it is not greater than equal to H3, then we will add one full day to the end time to represent the time on the next day and subtract the start time. Let me refresh it. If not, which is with if value is false, then we will add one full day to the end time, which is the timeout, to represent the time on the next day. Okay, we will add one full day to this much and represent as a time to the next full day and subtract the starting time. So how are we gonna do that? Just click this, it'll be one minus this and close it down here. Let's see what it gives. So it gives 8 hours. I know the AM part is the just denoter. So what we're gonna do here is we're gonna format this particular cell and keep it like this. Click OK. So we have the 8 hours timing left for the Joseph. And if we apply to all, it will work the same. Hope you get the point here. How we can do it with the help of time difference formula here. So now if you want to, you know, calculate as a decimal value, right? If you want to add, you don't want to show this like hour and minutes format, you can also edit the formula and multiply by 24 to calculate the difference between two times in hours as a decimal value. Multiply the previous formula, which is this formula, by 24 and change the number format to general. How are we going to do that? Just apply to the 25 here. Now click the format cell, general, it's here. So how many hours has left? 8. And if apply to all, so we get the 8 hours left. So when we just add some time here, 8 hours left. So that's how you can perform the time differences in Excel. So if you have learned something, please click the like button. If you have some questions in mind, you have full comment box with you. And if you want to subscribe to our channel for further updates regarding the Excel, and if you want to learn the advanced part of the Excel and each and every part or aspects of the Excel, you can also subscribe to our channel. See you in the next video. Until then, bye bye.